Hey everyone, still working on our surgery series, going under to get a total knee replacement here soon, and I want to talk about just my thinking. Now, one of the things that happens is most of us, when we have a kind of big orthopedic surgery, either referred to physical therapy or referred to rehab, or there's a little gap in between. Now, we'll get into some healing times and how that matters in terms of thinking about when do you need to challenge and all those things. But one of the things I'm looking at is how can I get just input into the system? So here we are, I'm gonna be basically resurfacing my knee. And one of the things that we have to appreciate is even in the Eastern traditions, they think of the joints as sort of lesser chakras, which for you maybe is not sort of in the language that you're used to, but think of this as a highly rich environment where my brain is getting a lot of information about my position, my state, my balance. Basically, a lot of proprioception is housed in the joint. So one of the things that happens after any surgery is that those systems can be downregulated or interrupted, especially when there's a lot of effusion or swelling in those tissues. So of course I have a good swelling strategy, compression, elevation. I've got my H wave, I'll be in the Normatec boots. I'll just be doing everything I can to encourage sort of the circulation of movements and blood flow in the system. But I'm also looking at what are the things that I can have in my house to really just upregulate my feeling, my awareness of my position. So, you know, sometimes we see a lot of those low-level balance drills being done in physical therapy clinics, et cetera, et cetera. And it's easy from the outside to say, why am I doing that? Aren't I working on balance all the time? I train standing up, I lift standing up, I move or jump in. But when we have sort of altered function, altered mechanics, having a couple sort of cues in your environment to work on it is really important. And I'd much rather you do 30 seconds times 50 throughout the day, or you have 21-minute bouts, then you know, work on something for a little bit and then come down. Now, what's gonna happen, of course, is that I'm gonna be able to initially, I'm probably not gonna be able to balance very well. You know, the joint will be stable and I'll have to respect being up, being down, being up, being down. But I just wanna show you two of the tools that I have in my house so that I can be working on these things all the time. And again, it's about upregulating this connection between where I am in space and how my brain is thinking all about that. So the first one is the SlackBlock, which we've talked about before. And our friends at SlackBow make this, and they've done a super creative job of basically creating a slack line in your home. And what's nice about the slack line in my home is that it's easy for me to work on balance and awareness, and I can even use my other foot as balance. So I don't have to commit to having the full Monty here. But what's great about this is that this allows me to change my foot position, be challenging lines front and backwards on this thing, making sure that I can work on breathing and balancing, and I can basically modify or modulate the amount of control by using my other leg. So even just figuring out how to be in long lever and control for short lever or shorter lever, and just putting some awareness into my system besides walking from the couch or the bedroom to the kitchen is a big deal. Our friends at the Foot Collective also have these very, very clever, simple balance beams. This one I made with some speed rail, just from Amazon. But just having access to a balance beam in your kitchen can make a big difference in terms of how you're challenging that foot system. So what's nice about both of these things is notice that they are hard surfaces on soft surfaces, or hard surface, but it gives my foot a chance to work and then balance underneath it. Sometimes if you're on soft Airex foam or foam, then my brain, basically I don't have an end range to go to, as an aside. So what I want to show you though is that I have a couple ways where I can be working on getting input into my brain all the time to get this brain-knee connection reestablished. I'm going to always be fighting uphill a little bit. I have post-surgical trauma, I've got all the swelling, I'm gonna have pain inhibition. There's a lot going on there, but my goal is to keep my brain as plugged into this knee as I can. And in that opportunity, and especially in that first week, my brain is really looking for trying to figure out, again, where it is in space and time. And the more safe dosing of this input I get, the better off I'll be. Both of these things are living in my life all the time anyway. I'm always working on them. I have good baselines. I'm pretty comfortable with it. But understand that our goal is not to think of rehab or restorative exercise is a discrete thing that happens for 30 minutes to 45 minutes or an hour, and then the rest of the day is devoid of input. The goal is to get as much input into the tissues systematically as we can, so that obviously we don't just over-challenge the tissues and blow them out, but I'm talking about working on balance. And if you don't have any of these things, you could even be standing on a single leg working on these positions. But having a little bit of a game, putting them, giving yourself context is the name of the game. So this is sort of layer two of how I think about trying to get my leg reconnected after the surgery.